Yeah, my name is Martin Boots. I was here last year. I had the honor to talk about Sonic Pi. Who knows Sonic Pi? Okay, most of you. Sonic Pi is a live coding environment, or for some, it's a program with which you can teach young people programming while they make music. It's developed by Sam Aaron. And I did a short presentation where I live coded, and then I just showed some of the features of Sonic Pi. And I wanted to take the opportunity just to show you what I'm working on, what I'm doing with Sonic Pi now. Who of you knows what a monome is? Is probably just a few. So I started with this thing. It's an Arduino-based touchpad from Adafruit, and it's a sort of monome clone. And I didn't own a real monome because they are quite expensive, but I wanted one. And it's actually just a set of LEDs and switches, and you can control, well, whatever you want. You can use it to output MIDI or to output OSC. And I finally succeeded in using it. But then I bought a real monome. Well, not this one. This is the one with 128 LEDs. And it's used for, well, as a sort of decoupled controller. So you can use it to output, actually it speaks OSC. And you can also get feedback into it to control the LEDs. And it's basically used for musical applications with Max MSP. And I wanted to use it with Sonic Pi. So the next thing I did was sort of a prototype, because actually I'm really not a programmer, and I needed some sort of use case before I owned a monome. And I used OpenStage Control, which is a quite nice graphical environment to develop interfaces like that, which work on the basis of OSC, Open Sound Control. And I did a prototype which controlled, which is a sort of sample application. And now I have just finished the sort of alpha version of this thing, which uses a real monome. That's, so to say, the, oops. So you have, basically, you have four tracks, or let's say four samples, which are mapped to these tracks, and they are sliced into 16 slices. You can control with this part, you can control the amp. So this is amp off. It's a sort of, well, it's a contradiction, but it's a stepped fader with only five steps. So you can start a track, you can set the volume. You can record, usually they start from here and they just run and play the sample in the original order, the slices in the original order. You can, for instance, push two buttons, this one and that one, and reverse the direction, or you can just play parts of the sample. It's actually the main idea comes from what's called MLR, which is a monome application just to control samples. There's another bit which is which can record live input. And the idea is to use Sonic Pi not only for live coding, but to have some control via such a controller, for instance, to just play a bass line with a synth or whatever, to record it, and to get it back into the live coding flow to, for instance, change or manipulate the sample. Because just writing, for instance, a bass line with code needs quite some time. So I'd rather record it, or I use a pre-configured sample. And I have a very small and very alpha demo here, which I'm going to play. And you can see and get an idea. One more thing, if I have the time. There's also a parameter page. So you can for any a track. So we have four tracks playing. If you just toggle them, playing pre-recorded samples, and you have four tracks playing these ones, playing recorded samples. And if I, for instance, hit this button, I'm on parameter page one, which controls the first sample, and I can set low-pass filter, high-pass filter rate, pitch, attack, and things like that. I can control this from the parameter pages. And here's a short demo. So here I'm choosing the sample for this track. This is on the parameter page. You see the four tracks run, but only one is right now. You can hear just run one. Well, this is actually the attack, sustain and attack. I can control while these buttons. This is still the parameter page. I'm just testing, just messing around with it. This is low-pass filter setting, high-pass filter setting. Now I'm going back to the main page. This is activating the second, the sample which is mapped to the second row. If you press a button, you just repeat this slice. And here's now a range, set a range, and just play four slices. Can you see this one is running backwards now? And I'm just messing around with the settings. I'm choosing another sample for, I think, yeah, I'm on number four. One, two, three, four. So I think you got the idea. This is actually here, you can't really see it. You can see here the logs running. This is running on Sonic Pi. And I'm planning, well, once I have a musical setting what I need, I'm planning, I can, for instance, go on and tweak this thing via live coding and add some other samples, add other stuff, and have a ground which I, a musical ground which I can control via the mono. That's the idea. Or, for instance, to work with some live musician, and while he's playing, just with this part of record samples from the live input, and then manipulate it via live coding. So that's the idea. Okay.